स्कूली शिक्षा में गुणवत्ता और उत्कृष्टता लाने की दृष्टि से भारत सरकार के मानव संसाधन विकास मंत्रालय ने निष्ठा एक कार्यक्रम जिसमें सभी अध्यापकों को और जिला प्रमुखों को और जो भी शिक्षा से जुड़े लोग हैं उनको प्रशिक्षण का एक बहुत बड़ा कार्यक्रम है। मैं समझता हूँ निष्ठा पूरी दुनिया का सबसे बड़ा ऐसा कार्यक्रम है जिसमें 42 लाख अध्यापकों को प्रशिक्षण दिया जाना है। मुझे इस बात की खुशी है कि जहाँ 4 राज्यों में मध्य प्रदेश, छत्तीसगढ़, जम्मू और कश्मीर और बिहार में ये जो राज्य स्तरीय प्रशिक्षण शुरू है, वहीं 23 राज्यों के लगभग सभी जिला स्तर पर ये प्रशिक्षण कार्यक्रम शुरू हो गया। और आज मुझे खुशी है कि आज आंध्र प्रदेश में ये देश का पहला निष्ठा का ऑनलाइन प्रशिक्षण होगा। मैं आंध्र प्रदेश के शिक्षा मंत्री को बधाई देना चाहता हूँ, आंध्र प्रदेश के शिक्षा मंत्री जी, आपकी पूरी टीम को, शिक्षा के जितने अधिकारी हैं उनको मैं बधाई देना चाहता हूँ कि जो आज ये ऑनलाइन, क्योंकि देश में क्या दुनिया में जो एकाएक परिस्थिति आई है, जो कोरोना के महासंकट से होकर के गुजर रही है पूरी दुनिया, उसमें मेरे देश के शिक्षकों की बहुत ही अहम भूमिका रही है, जिन्होंने बच्चों को अभिभावकों के साथ मिलकर के और अध्ययन के लिए ऑनलाइन सुनिश्चित किया है। मुझे लगता है ये भी दुनिया का एक अद्भुत उदाहरण है, क्योंकि मेरे देश के 33 करोड़ छात्र छात्राएं हैं जो अमेरिका की जनसंख्या से भी ज़्यादा हैं, और इसलिए दुनिया के सबसे बड़े लोकतांत्रिक देश के इतने व्याप्त शिक्षा के क्षेत्र में आज आंध्र प्रदेश ऑनलाइन अपना शिक्षा प्रशिक्षण शुरू कर रहा है। तो मैं NCERT को इस बात के लिए शुभकामना देना चाहता हूँ कि एक अच्छा काम हो रहा है, और जो ऑनलाइन का जो पाठ्यक्रम हम लोगों ने शुरू किया है, ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन शुरू किया है, ऐसे समय में अध्यापकों का प्रशिक्षण और भी ज़रूरी हो जाता है। और इसलिए आज जो निष्ठा पोर्टल पर, जो दीक्षा पोर्टल पर, निष्ठा पोर्टल पर जो ये प्रशिक्षण शुरू होगा अध्यापकों का, वो अपने आप में एक अभिनव होगा। और इसके लिए मैं सभी अध्यापकों से, क्योंकि पहले जो अध्यापक होंगे राज्य स्तर पर होंगे, फिर जिला स्तर पर होंगे, वो जो प्रशिक्षित होंगे वो आम अध्यापकों तक नीचे जाकर के प्रशिक्षण देंगे। और ये संख्या लगभग मुझे लगता है कि जैसे 23,000 प्रमुख लोगों को, जो जो राज्य स्तर के प्रमुख लोग होंगे वो प्रशिक्षित हुए हैं, जबकि 17 लाख से भी अधिक अध्यापकों को प्रशिक्षण मिला है, और अभी 24 लाख से भी अधिक जो अध्यापक हैं उनको उस श्रृंखला में प्रशिक्षण पाना है। तो मैं बधाई देता हूँ, NCERT को बधाई देना चाहता हूँ, आंध्र प्रदेश के शिक्षा विभाग को, उन्होंने ये पहल की है। मुझे भरोसा है कि जो चुनौती के समय में हम इसका मुकाबला कर रहे हैं, और बच्चे को किसी तरीके से छात्र छात्राएं ऑनलाइन पढ़ाई के लिए उसको एक माहौल दे रहे हैं, और जो बच्चा अभी अंतिम छोर पर है उसको तक भी हमको जाना है, और जिसमें स्वयं प्रभा के माध्यम से हम वन क्लास वन चैनल का अभियान, जो हमारे देश के प्रधानमंत्री जी का मन में था, प्रधानमंत्री ई विद्या के तहत जिस तरीके से वन नेशन वन डिजिटल प्लेटफॉर्म का उनका विज़न है, और वन क्लास वन चैनल, ताकि अंतिम छोर तक का बच्चा भी, जिसके पास स्मार्ट टेलीफोन नहीं है, नेट नहीं है, वो बच्चा भी टेलीविज़न में अपने पाठ्यक्रमों को देख सकेगा, पढ़ सकेगा, ज़रूरत पड़ेगी तो रेडियो को भी लेंगे। और राज्य बहुत अच्छा काम कर रहे हैं इस दिशा में। मैं एक बार फिर आप सबको शुभकामनाएं देता हूं, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
निष्ठा नेशनल इनिशिएटिव फॉर स्कूल हेड्स एंड टीचर्स होलिस्टिक एडवांसमेंट। मानव संसाधन विकास मंत्रालय भारत सरकार द्वारा समग्र शिक्षा के अंतर्गत प्रारंभिक शिक्षा कक्षा 1 से 8 के लगभग 42 लाख शिक्षकों के प्रशिक्षण की एक अभूतपूर्व राष्ट्रीय पहल। अपनी विस्तृत पहुंच के साथ संभवतः निष्ठा है संपूर्ण विश्व का सबसे बड़ा शिक्षक प्रशिक्षण कार्यक्रम। निष्ठा में स्कूल प्रमुख भी अपनी नेतृत्व क्षमता निखार सकेंगे और सुनिश्चित करेंगे बच्चों में व्यक्तिगत और सामाजिक गुणों का विकास। प्रशिक्षण से शिक्षक छात्रों में रचनात्मक चिंतन विकसित करने के लिए होंगे प्रेरित और सक्षम। उनमें विकसित होगी शुरुआती परामर्शदाता बनने की प्रतिभा, जिसमें शामिल होगी पॉक्सो और RPWD एक्ट की जानकारी। रटने वाली विधियों से हटकर शिक्षक बनाएंगे अपने शिक्षण को तनाव रहित, रोचक और आनंददायी। साथ ही कर पाएंगे विभिन्न विषयों में ICT कला समेकित एवं दक्षता आधारित शिक्षण, जिससे बेहतर होंगे विद्यार्थियों के लर्निंग आउटकम्स। निष्ठा में मिलेगी समग्र शिक्षा के विभिन्न पहलुओं की समझ भी, जैसे योग और स्वास्थ्य, यूथ व इको क्लब, खेल कूद सामग्री, स्कूल अनुदान और पुस्तकालय इत्यादि। प्रशिक्षण के तहत शिक्षण की गुणवत्ता बढ़ाने के लिए NCERT, नीपा, केंद्रीय विद्यालय संगठन, नवोदय विद्यालय समिति, CBSE, यूनिसेफ तथा अन्य संस्थाओं के लगभग 120 विषय विशेषज्ञ सम्मिलित होंगे। साथ ही होंगे देश के सभी राज्यों और संघ शासित प्रदेशों के SCERT, DIET, BRC, CRC के लगभग 33,000 प्रशिक्षक और 42 लाख शिक्षक भी, जो देंगे शिक्षकों को बहुउद्देशीय, बहुआयामी और समेकित प्रशिक्षण। निष्ठा में उपलब्ध होगा एक विश्वसनीय पोर्टल और मोबाइल ऐप, जो उपलब्ध कराएगा गुणवत्तापूर्ण ई सामग्री, प्रशिक्षण से जुड़ी सभी जानकारी। इसमें शिक्षक साझा करेंगे अपने अनुभव कि कैसे प्रशिक्षण के बाद वे दे रहे हैं बाल केंद्रित अधिगम को अंजाम। तो आइए जुड़ें निष्ठा के साथ, पूरी निष्ठा से।
Honorable Minister of State, Ministry of Human Resource Development, Sri Sanjay Dhotra ji, Honorable Minister of Education, Sri A. Suresh ji, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Secretary School Education and Literacy, Madam Anita Karwal ji, Secretary Department of Education, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Raj Sekhar ji, Vice Chancellor NIPA, Professor N.V. Varghese, Commissioner Navodaya Vidyalaya Samiti, Commissioner Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan, Chairperson NIUS, Chairperson CBSE, all the invited members and other members from Ministry of Human Resource Development. I am very happy to inform you that we are going to launch online NISTA in Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh is the 34th state where this program is going to be launched. We have launched this program in 33 states. I am very happy to inform that we have provided this training to 23,000 key resource persons out of 33,000 through face-to-face mode. In the same way, we have provided teacher training to 17.5 lakhs teachers and school heads out of 42 lakhs. And this program has been initiated, the program for teacher training has been initiated for teachers in 23 states. This is a great achievement for all of us. We want our teachers should be professionally sound. Teachers should be competent so that they can contribute significantly in nation building. They can prepare our children in a better way, and ultimately they will be good citizen of this country. Keeping in view this, we have prepared 17 modules under this NISTA program, and this time we have also added one more, keeping in view this COVID situation. And here you will find the modules, one category of module that is for the holistic development of the learner. All the time our focus is on attainment of learning outcome. That is why we have kept curriculum, inclusive education, gender issues, socio-personal qualities, particularly development of socio-personal qualities, and health and well-being. And all these will help our children in the development of all their innate potentialities. That is our focus. And to achieve this, we have identified or we have developed some modules which are very, very important from strategic point of view, because we all know ICT is coming in a very big way and it has influenced every walk of life. And this information technology, information and communication technology in education is most important module, and we are going to use this to strengthen our classroom process to facilitate learning. Similarly, to make learning more joyful, more meaningful, more interesting, more attractive, we have introduced art integrated learning, which will be used by the teachers while transacting different school subjects in different areas, just to make learning joyful. Similarly, we want that classroom process should be more vibrant, and school based assessment should be highlighted, and assessment should be integrated with teaching learning, so that this process, classroom process, will be strengthened. That is most important. All these are the strategic module we have included in this, under this NISTA package. Then we have highlighted the subject specific area, the pedagogy of science, pedagogy of mathematics, pedagogy of language, pedagogy of social science, and pedagogy of environmental studies. And all these are essential for our teachers to transact their respective subjects in a very meaningful way, so that student will enjoy learning. Similarly, we have also kept some module keeping in view the systemic issue. All of us know, if our school leader is very dynamic, then our school education will be effective. And along with the teachers, we want our school head should participate. Keeping in view that, we have included module on leadership, and NIPA Vice Chancellor is present here. NIPA has contributed in the development of this module. And we have modules on preschool education, pre-vocational education, and also module we have developed keeping in view this COVID-19 situation, so that our children will be in a position to address all the challenges and face all the issues what they will come across. So that is why this module we have developed, keeping in view the holistic development of the child. And after undergoing this training, our teacher will be proficient, their proficiency will be developed, and they can contribute significantly in transacting their subjects and make learning more effective, and teaching learning process will be more vibrant, our classroom will be more vibrant, and it will contribute in all round development of our children. Just I would like to mention one thing, that we want our focus should be shifted from content mastery to competency mastery, because we are in 21st century. We are all the time we are talking about creativity, critical thinking, problem solving ability, communication skills, and we expect all our children to develop all these skills and competency, so that they can face any challenge they can address any issue and there will be no difficulty for them. They can compete with any children in any part of the world, because it is our moral responsibility to help our children to develop their innate potentialities, to prepare them for life. If we can strengthen their information processing system, then they on their own can learn in a better way, and we want they should be autonomous learner, and we just should facilitate, and our assessment should be integrated with teaching learning. That is why we are focusing more on assessment as learning. And I hope this NISTA program will definitely bring about a change in our school education. It will help us in improving the quality, particularly in the attainment of learning outcome, because now we are trying to make everything learning outcome centered. That is the best, and keeping in view the learning outcome, the competency skill, we are doing everything. And I hope all the school heads, all the teachers will take advantage of this program. I am thankful to Government of Andhra Pradesh, and I am very happy that Honorable Minister of Education, Government of Andhra Pradesh, is present here, and the Secretary School Education, Government of Andhra Pradesh is also present here, and our Honorable Minister has also delivered his speech in the beginning. I am grateful to our Honorable Minister Sri Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank ji, because all the time he inspires us and he appreciate that you do good work, and we are doing good work just for the benefit of our country, for the keeping in view the interest of our children. And I am very grateful to our Honorable Minister of State Sri Sanjay Dhotre ji for his kind presence, and I hope all of you will enjoy this program, and after conducting this program definitely we'll get some satisfaction that our teachers are proficient enough to bring about change in education system. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for giving us a backdrop about the NISTA, and also the way forward as far as NISTA version 2 is concerned. Now I request Professor N.V. Varghese, Vice Chancellor, National Institute of Educational Planning and Administration, NIPA, to kindly address the audience.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for inviting me. Honorable Minister of Human Resource Development Sri Ramesh Pokhriyal ji, and Honorable Minister of State for Human Resource Development Sri Sanjay Dhotre, and Madam Anita Karwal, Secretary School Education in the MHRD, and Honorable Minister in the State of Andhra Pradesh, and Honorable Secretary in the State of Andhra Pradesh, and my colleagues in NCERT, and my director, the director of NCERT, and his colleagues, and my colleagues in NIPA, and all other people, all other participants. It gives me immense pleasure, and I consider it to be an honor. It's very important to notice that in the 1950s, 60s, and 70s, our major effort was the question that was posed to us, how to bring children to the schools. And you find that in the 80s and 90s, the focus shifted to not only bringing children to the school, but also creating facilities to improve the qualities. So we had the Operation Blackboard strategies in the 1980s. We find that cluster resource centers, block resource centers, etc., were created to provide academic support to the teachers. However, we rarely came to school as a unit, and we rarely came to school processes and practices that are taking place, school as a unit for intervention and action. I think one of the important dimensions of this program, NISTA program, is that we not only focus on classrooms and schools, the practices there, but also on teaching learning processes along with the leadership activities, along with the school as a unit, as it was very rightly pointed out by the director of NCERT, that the holistic development of the child, holistic development of children, that becomes the focus. And that is one of the reasons why NIPA and NCERT are coming together. in our own areas of expertise. I would like to say that NCERT has been contributing substantially in the area of teachers, teacher development, teaching learning processes, etc. And NEPA has been from 1962 for the past 58 years, NEPA has been contributing substantially in facilitating a process of planning at the national level, state level, district level, block level, and even at the institutional level. So it is from this perspective that NEPA has been very happy to be collaborating with the NCERT under the auspices of MHRD for this program. NEPA's, there is a center that was established, National Center for School Leadership. They have been working in this area of development of school leadership in all the schools, focusing more on the public schools initially, but it is not confined to the government schools alone. And they have developed modules, and this also will be one of the aspects of the teaching learning or transaction of this training program. And you will find that this will be one way of looking at as a school as a unit for intervention, school as a unit for not only curriculum transaction, but also for overall holistic development of the child, you know. So that is the way that we are trying to see. And I would like to express my gratitude and thankfulness to invite my colleagues in the preparation of the modules and also in the transaction processes. And I am specifically happy that I am also a part of or participating in this, again, amongst this august audience in this event, in this moment of, in this great moment of inauguration of this program. I thank you very much once again.
Thank you very much, Professor Varghese ji, for the continued support of NEPA during the NISTA program. And I hope that we will be getting continuous support for the online version also we have been receiving. Thank you very much. And now I request Professor Ranjana Arora ji, Head Department of Teacher Education, NCERT, to please go ahead with the presentation about the NISTA online 2.0, how we are going about in the state of Andhra Pradesh. Professor Ranjana Arora ji.
Namaskar. I'm happy to invite Honorable Minister of State for HRD, Shri Sanjay Dhotre ji. Honorable Minister of Education, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Dr. A. Suresh ji. Respected Secretary, School Education, Mrs. Anita Karwal ji. Respected Principal Secretary, School Education, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Shri B. Rajshekhar ji. Respected Professor Senapati, Director NCERT. Respected Professor N.V. Varghese, Vice Chancellor, NEPA. Joint Director NCERT, Joint Director CIT NCERT, esteemed officials from Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan, Navodaya Vidyalaya Samiti, NEPA, NIOS and CBSE, and very esteemed officials, and of course, and also faculty members from NCERT, and very, very dear participants from Andhra Pradesh. So it is my proud privilege to invite our honorable ministers of state for HRT, Shri Sanjay Dhotre ji, and also honorable minister of education, government of Andhra Pradesh, Shri A. Suresh ji. I am just giving you a brief of NISTA online. So I request for the presentation. This is a shift from or you can say that it is continuation of NISTA face to face towards NISTA online. NISTA online has the features intact from the face to face which we have taken. NISTA aims at developing professionally our teachers, school heads, KRPs and state resource persons who are already trained by the NEPA. And NISHTHA also aims at providing lots of quality teaching learning resources to teachers so that they can utilize those resources in their classrooms. NISHTHA also empowers teachers and school heads to create and share lots of resources contextualized to their needs or needs of their children. NISHTHA also aims at providing continuous mentoring and support to the teachers up to the classroom level. If you see everywhere we have written NISHTHA integrated. So, what is this this integrative perspective of NISHTHA? NISHTHA integrated, why we are writing this? Because NISHTHA integrates on many aspects. You can see that there are target groups, integrated target groups. School heads are also there with teachers. Block level, state level, district level functionaries are also with teachers. So, they all are learning together. NISHTHA integrates subject, pedagogy and emerging concerns. Subject specific modules are also there and concern specific, social, national concerns specific modules are also there in NISHTHA. NISHTHA also integrates assessment. In each of the module, we have assessment exercises inbuilt. NISHTHA also integrates mechanisms, different kinds of mechanisms. And nevertheless, NISHTHA also integrates institutions. We all institutions work together to bring out NISHTHA in this form. Coming to the modalities of NISHTHA, we can see that there are 33,000 key resource persons and state resource persons, leadership trained by NEPA. They all together going to train 42 lakh teachers in a group of 6 SRG. So, we have around 5,520 SRGs who are training our teacher, 42 lakh teachers. So, till now we have already covered, as Professor Senapati ji has already said, till now we have already covered 23,000 KRPs and 17.5 lakh teachers trained through face to face manner. But now online NISHTHA will be aiming to train 24 lakh more teachers and 10,000 more SRPs. In NISHTHA we have kept intact the feature of mapping. We have mapped SRG, NRP. We have at the NCRT level we have 120 national resource persons. These national resource persons are making 8 national resource groups. These 8 national resource group are mapped with SRG, 5,500 SRGs, and this 5,500 SRGs are mapped with 42 lakh teachers. So, one can see that it is not one time affair, it is continuous professional development. We handhold our teachers, we handhold our KRPs and our resource persons so that we can go up to the classroom level. And in NISHTHA we have generated lots of resources. We have developed primer, we have developed guidelines, we have developed modules. Now we have 18 modules in place, and these modules are not only in printed form, but also now these are customized to the Diksha format and they are available in online form. We have also generated lots of e-resources so that teacher can have access to quality resources. Videos are also there so that not only reading material, but also they can see, they can watch videos. And NISHTHA also keep interactivity intact. Teachers can talk to SRPs, teacher can talk to KRP, teacher can talk to NRP. So, both in all the channels are open for our teachers to talk to us. So, these are in brief major features of NISHTHA, and about the modules, Professor Senapati has also has already clarified that in our modules we are shifting from rote memorization methods to competency based methods. We are also have lots of quizzes, games, and other interactive activities in our Nishtha modules. So I hope our teachers and our KRPs will enjoy this training. They have enjoyed in face-to-face manner, we know, but now they will also enjoy this training through online mode, because we are not going away from this interactivity. We will be keeping these interactivity intact. So with this, I would request now Professor Amrinder Behra to give us an overview of technical aspect of Nishtha, that how can we do this online courses. Thank you. Namaskar.
Thank you very much, Professor Ranjana Arora ji, and also I join hand with Professor Senapati, Professor Varghese, and Professor Ranjana Arora ji to welcome all the honorable dignitaries, the honorable Minister of Human Resource Development (MOS), Government of India, honorable Secretary MHRD, and the senior officers from MHRD. Even Honorable Minister of Education, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Honorable Secretary, and distinguished NRG members, all the principals of RIs, Joint Director PSSCIB, and also NCERT, and all NCERT colleagues and Andhra Pradesh colleagues for joining this program. And as Professor Ranjana ji has already mentioned, that as a part of Nishtha online program, we will be having a portal and a mobile app. The screenshot is already available with it, and I think it is visible for all of you. All the resources have been uploaded on the portal and the mobile app also, which can be downloaded by all the SRG members from Andhra Pradesh, and they can be used. And as Professor Ranjana ji mentioned, the modules are also in different languages, including the Telugu version resources are also uploaded on the portal. And 24/7, these resources are available on the portal. As a part of the online course portal, so we'll have all the training resources materials here, and also we'll have additional web resources on the portal. And to increase the interactivity during the program, we have a discussion forum inbuilt into it in the portal, and the teachers and the SRG members, they can interact with the NRG members on 24/7 basis using the forum, discussion forum created on the portal. And also we'll have a complete training portfolio, trainees portfolio, all the training trainee details will be there. We have so far received 1200 SRG members list, which has already been mapped on the portal. We will have a complete database of the training, how many teachers are undergoing this training, how many teachers are going to complete, and also module wise, all the teachers can provide feedback in each module. There are video tutorials also that how to log in, how to use the resources, how to use the modules. So those tutorials also available there. And we have a system of attendance also, how many teachers are coming to the portal, who is watching the videos, and who is watching, reading the text modules. So those details will also be available, and the training management system enables that. If I take you through the next slide, the course materials will be available like this, and the current activity, so those will be there, and the video tutorials will be available on this icon, and resources will be available on the green icon as mentioned here. Even we have a training provision of having training daily training reports. So daily training reports will be available on the portal on a dashboard, and states can also upload the training report on daily basis and update also. And we have also provision of having a gallery of photographs and images and videos uploaded by the state and the teachers. And also we have provision of putting media highlights of any program, like the program we are going to start in the state of Andhra Pradesh. And similarly, showcase of best practices done by the teachers and the mentors, that also is possible through this portal. And the dashboard will cover all the 120 NRG members, 33,000 SRG members, and the 42 lakh teachers which will be coming So they will also be, the data will be populated here. I was talking about the discussion forum. The discussion forum will look like this. Suppose a discussion forum is on Indian languages. So the teachers can discuss that how Telugu can be taught to children, and the experts at the national level, NRG members, can respond. Similarly, if the teachers would like to further know about universal design of learning as far as inclusive education is concerned and all other concerns are there, they can continuously talk to the resource persons continuously. So also, these are the four major steps we'll be following during this training program. We'll have registration and login. So far, we have registered all the teachers of Andhra Pradesh, all the 1200 SRG members of Andhra Pradesh after receiving the list. So they will be given the login IDs and the passwords soon, and they can log in and see the resources. And they will have to take a pre-test, a pre-training assessment, we call it. So through pre-training assessment, we will be looking at their entry behavior. And also, they will be reading all the modules and listen to the materials and videos also they will watch. And we'll have continuous interaction with the teachers through multiple modes. We'll have a 1 hour DTH TV transmission on alternative days when the modules are unfolded and we start doing the course. And also at the end of the module, all the courses are taken by the teachers, by the SRG members, will have post-training assessment. We have a provision of providing feedback on each module, and at last there will be certification. So these will be the four major steps which will be followed to take up this online course. And if I take you through, the mobile app will look like this. This is the first left side screen, is the splash screen, and the next screen is the landing page. So it will be all the courses and details, including frequently asked questions, best practices, videos, web tutorials, all are available here, and teachers can do that. Even the language modules are available here, so teachers can select different language modules and they can read also, as I mentioned. And these are the course modules already mentioned by Professor Senapati and Professor Ranjana, the detailed course modules. And we have also embedded a QR code of the website and the mobile app. So by scanning this, the SRG members can go further. To end, I must say that we have enabled IVRS system also, interactive voice response system, using which any teacher from any corner of Andhra Pradesh, so they can speak to the national level resource persons. And once the 1200 state resource groups of Andhra Pradesh are trained in the subsequent these 2 months' time, so they also can be ready for answering to the questions of the teachers and teacher educators from the state. So since it will be 1200 resource state resource persons ready, so even with the Telugu language, so they can help the teachers also at different district, block and village level. With these words, I once again thank all of you for the present hearing. So now I request Sri B. Rajasekhar Garu, IAS, Principal Secretary, School Education, Government of Andhra Pradesh, to please address the audience.
Thank you, Beharaji. Namaskar to all the participants. Shri Sanjay Dhotre Ji, Honorable Minister of State for MHRD, Government of India. Madam Secretary Anita Karwal Ji, our Honorable Minister for Education, Sri Adimulapu Suresh Ji, Professor Hrishikesh Senapati Ji, and Professor N.V. Varghese Ji, Vice Chancellor NEPA. At the outset, on behalf of the Government of AP and Department of School Education, I would like to thank MHRD and NCERT for giving us this opportunity for being the first state to pilot the online version of Nishtha. I would like to clarify that last year the state of AP could not participate in the Nishtha program because of the conflicting priority program that we had. Our Honorable Chief Minister launched the English medium education in the state, and we were planning to train all our teachers in the new medium of instruction. And because of that clash, we requested NCERT that AP may be exempted from launching the Nishtha program last year. And we are extremely grateful now that you, thanks to COVID, the online version has now been developed excellently. We've just gone through the different modules and the way the entire online version has been designed by both NCERT and NEPA. And I'm sure, in fact, we have a very vibrant teaching community in AP. We have a very vibrant SCRT. In fact, recently we've developed new textbooks, you know, using our internal resources, of course, taking help of NCERT and other institutions. But we have a very robust and very highly motivated teaching community in this state. And I'm sure this Nishtha program will help the teachers enhance their capabilities so that they'll be able to do a better job in the classroom. In fact, my team, we went to Delhi and we had a first-hand experience of participating in one of the Nishtha training programs, and we also interacted with the teachers, and we realized how important it is to invest in teachers. I think Delhi government has done that, and we see that in the way some of the teachers, at least we interacted with, they are performing. I think at least I can share that in the state, teacher training has been a neglected program. And I think Nishtha will set high standards and will also enable us to do some more training programs along with Nishtha. And as I've said, we will look at it as an investment. Investment in teachers is actually an investment in our future citizens, because a well-equipped teacher will be able to provide that 360-degree kind of a learning experience to the child. So I'll stop here and again thank both NCERT, NEPA and MHRD for giving us this opportunity.
I now request Honorable Director NCERT, Professor Senapati, to formally invite Dr. A. Suresh Garu, Honorable Minister of Education, Government of Andhra Pradesh, for the address. Professor Senapati.
Thank you, Professor Behra. I'm really very happy that Honorable Minister of Education, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri A. Suresh Ji is with us, and I request the Honorable Minister to deliver his speech.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. At the very outset, on this auspicious occasion of launching the online integrated teacher training program called Nishtha, National Initiative for School Heads and Teachers for their holistic advancement. So, respected Ramesh Pokhriyalji, the team leader of this human resource development of this country, and the Honorable Minister for HRD, Government of India, Sri Sanjay Dhotreji, Minister of State for HRD, Government of India, Madam Anita Karwalji, Secretary School Education and Literacy, Government of India. Professor Hrishikesh Senapathiji, Director, NCERT, and the moving spirit behind this Anishta program and the entire online this training program, and all the distinguished personalities of school education department of the country. On behalf of the government of Andhra Pradesh and especially on behalf of our honorable Chief Minister Sri Vaya Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu, I convey my warm greetings to all of you and especially the HRD Department of Government of India. Thank you so much, sir. And as you all know that now this entire academic year, you know, how much ever we have planned, the more we are planning and then more we are deviating from this planning. And this academic year, you know, I don't know whether it is heading towards zero academic year, as all people are, all the press and then in the media, they are predicting. Despite that, HRD is really, you know, showing us the direction and really doing hand-holding of all the states, especially in putting things in proper place, especially by giving guidelines, either in terms of, you know, the SOPs for the, you know, running of these online courses and, you know, training of teachers and then training of, and the teaching learning both process has really taken a total change, and it has really, you know, we have come out of box thinking, and this pandemic COVID-19 has really given us an opportunity in the amidst crisis to go for this online learning and then teaching process, whether it is for teachers or the students. I'm really very appreciative about the initiative taken by the NCERT, especially for the teachers. We have almost around 1.46 lakh teacher community teaching to various classes from 1 to 10. And as we all would agree that, you know, academic administration is something which is wanting for the heads, especially school heads. This is one area, in fact, we have not got any scientific way of teaching to the school heads, except that we have this university at the Government of India level. Not many states have taken initiatives. So I think now with this online training programs, I'm sure this teacher heads and then teaching community as a whole will really get benefited. And I just want to take you around to some of the initiatives which the government of Andhra Pradesh under the dynamic leadership of our Chief Minister Sri Vaya Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu, we have embarked upon in the last 1 year of our tenure in the office. We have taken over the governance last year, and in 1 year of time, we have really taken a lot of initiatives, not in the mere form of numbers and the figures, but actually in our deeds also. Because as you all know that in Andhra Pradesh, nearly 10 million children, maybe in schools or junior colleges or degree colleges, they are in the safe hands of our education department. And when it comes to government of India, the figure may be around 300 or 350 million, something like that. So such a huge, you know, student community is in our hands. And then the greatest task of, you know, showing this younger generation the future, especially their employment skills, and then, you know, building up a very responsive society. I think any amount of expenditure incurred in the education department should be viewed as an investment on the future generations and investment in the society. This is the one dictum on which actually the reforms and the initiatives what we have embarked upon Andhra Pradesh in the last 1 year. The formula is very, very simple. We have decided that education should be accessible, education should be affordable, education should have equity, and education finally should have, last but not least, equality. equity is one area which is terribly missing, especially when it comes to children belong to below poverty. So this area we have addressed it, and in fact we have addressed it very strongly. And as the father of the Indian Constitution, Dr. Babasaheb B.R. Ambedkar, has said that poverty should not be a barrier for education. Precisely, our Honorable Chief Minister, being a visionary, he has taken up this concept. And then we have taken up a mammoth program of Nadu Nedu, especially the conversion of all the schools in terms of infrastructure, what actually do have as of now. And in 3 years' time, we want to modify every school in terms of some specified parameters, like, you know, we don't have toilets, we don't have running water, and then we don't have green boards, we don't have compound walls, we don't have English labs. So these are the initiatives we have identified, and we have decided to spend almost 11,000 crores in a span of 3 years. So this is in action. Actually, this year itself, at the phase one, we have already allocated 3,700 crores. So let me tell you very, very clearly that we have to start with allocated almost 16% of our budget, not for 1 year, for the second consecutive year. This year also, in the very first year of our governance, we have allocated 33,000 crores out of a budget of 225 crores, which is constituting almost 16% of the budget for education department, both school education and higher education, technical and higher education. Similarly, for second year also, we have almost very closely to 32,000 crores we have allocated. So we believe that, you know, this is an investment for the future of these younger generations. We don't take it as an expenditure at all. This is the philosophy of, you know, development of education system in Andhra Pradesh is concerned. As you all know that, you know, the teacher community needs this sustained training program, and we need to enhance their skills, both in the you know, activity-based learning and competency-based learning. And in fact, much before this also, last year, we have started a program called Comprehensive Continuous Learning Program for teachers, especially when we started off introducing this English medium schools are concerned. We just want to give a level playing field. The people below the poverty line, especially in rural areas, so they have been denied of this English education, especially at primary and upper primary and high school. So this actually, we started off, and then we started on bridge courses, online bridge courses, and then we have gone ahead and printing bilingual textbooks. These are some of the initiatives which we have taken up, especially the primary education is concerned. In fact, we wanted to introduce pre-primary education in Andhra Pradesh by linking up with the Anganwadi centers. So Anganwadi centers and education department together, we are channelizing all the existing resources, and then we want to start off the pre-primary schools. And I'm very glad that, you know, in this very, you know, the difficult times, especially for education department is concerned, due to these lockdowns and due to these containment zones coming up, and then most of the educational institutions are being used as a containment centers in Andhra Pradesh. And then as you all know that, you know, the containment of this pandemic in Andhra Pradesh, actually we have shown a, you know, exemplary, you know, implementation strategy as far as the number of tests are concerned in education zones, and then, you know, especially migrant workers, rehabilitation. We have really shown a new path, especially in tackling this COVID-19 pandemic is concerned. But however, we don't know when this will end. It is anybody's guess. Until this vaccine is invented, we will not be able to say anything. But it doesn't mean that, you know, we can't do anything, especially as far as putting back the whole education academic calendar on track with this active support of Government of India, especially HRD. We are very, very thankful for really guiding us at every step, at every stage, whenever we are in doubt, and whenever when there is no way for us to come out of this crisis and all. Every time the Government of India HRD department has come to our rescue by, you know, guiding us properly as far as, you know, and especially, you know, the last one, and which is very important, the training of the trainees, that is the teachers are concerned. We have really got a very, very, very motivated team in Andhra Pradesh. And as I mentioned already, our Honorable Secretary, Principal Secretary, Ms. Ra Sekhar, has just given an outline of what are the initiatives we have taken. We have really, you know, done a lot of structural reforms as far as the education department is concerned. We have really, you know, started off, you know, the digital education department. We have really strengthened our SCR, the State Council for Education Research and Training, the sister organization of NCRT. And we have appointed many officers independently looking after these organizations, and they are highly motivated officers here. Mrs. Vita Selvi, our commissioner, Mr. Chinnavira Badrudu, and then we have got for midday meal scheme also, we have appointed midday meals and sanitation. We have appointed one state level officer of Volunteer Services who is looking after exclusively the midday meal scheme also. In fact, this scheme actually we have strengthened it, and we have called in terms of nutrient values and in terms of variety, in terms of the taste, and we have really we have added more you know, taste, and then, you know, variety, so that, you know, the enrollment for children, especially for the midday meal scheme, also tremendously increased. And then we have got a lot of cash incentive schemes, especially to increase the enrollment and decrease the dropout rate. We have got a scheme called Jagannanna Ammavadi. Ammavadi is a scheme. Ammavadi is Maati Goat. This is one scheme where we are giving incentives to mother almost 15,000 rupees every year for sending their children to the schools. And this scheme extended from class 1 to 5. So any mother who wants to send her child to school or children, we are giving them incentives. They have been very, you know, or the dropout ratio has really, you know, has come down drastically, and then enrollment ratio has increased. And then this is one of the novel schemes, I think, nowhere in the country it has been introduced. And the Honorable Chief Minister, along with this, we wanted to give a message to people that poverty need not be a barrier for higher education and especially technical education. So we are giving full fee reimbursement for professional courses, wherever, whichever college student is studying, in the form of Jagannanna Vidya Divana, and Vasati Divana, and for boarding expenditure also we are giving it. And now we are just waiting for the schools to reopen well, and the children on the other place also, they're waiting eagerly to, you know, come to schools, you know, because the new look of the schools, you know, which we are doing it at a cost of 11,000 crores in two phases. Along with that, all the textbooks, the bilingual textbooks, the notebooks, and three pairs of uniforms, belts and shoes in the form of, you know, Jagannanna Vidya Kanuka. And we want to give to every child who's coming to school. So we have really envisioned a lot of programs, especially to strengthen primary education and school education in Andhra Pradesh. And and as you all know that when it comes to government schools, it means a tuta-puta, you know, windows, doors, and then you know, all that build out roof, ceiling, and then, you know, all the worn out blackboards and all these will be the things of the past. Now we just want to make government schools on par with you know, any of these corporate schools. And we also want to ensure that, you know, the Right to Education Act, you know, the reservations, everything should be implementable in private sector also, because 43% of the students also study in private sector. We want to control, we want to monitor them, we want to regulate the quality of teaching education in private schools also. And for the first time in the country, we have enacted a law called Regulatory and Monitoring Commission for School Education. We have appointed a retired High Court judge to go into the infrastructural facilities available in every school, and accordingly they should fix the fees. There should be equity and there should be quality, and then accessibility is one area which actually we are strongly addressing. So I am sure this Nishtha program, which you are starting up in Andhra Pradesh, we will extend all possible support. Especially we got a very strong, highly motivated team at the state level and district level. And now that actually from the inputs what actually we gather from this Nishita, we would like to replicate in our states. And in fact, our Honorable Chief Minister also has said that this training process cannot be in one time. You just train one teacher and then he will be trained for lifetime. No, we don't believe in that. We just want to say that this should be a sustained program. For that, if we want to strengthen the diets, the diet, the district institute for education training, we want to strengthen it. We want to strengthen the diet institutes at the district level so that there should be a regular program for training of the teachers. And then finally, we want to integrate these diet colleges within one university, especially for teacher training. This is almost in advanced stages, and then very, very soon in the next legislative sessions, in assembly sessions, this bill also would be introduced, and then we pass an act for creating a university at Prakasham district, specifically for designing courses for teach training. And for all the methodologies and for management, teacher training management, as you rightly identified, there is a need to give an integrated training both for school heads and then teachers as a whole. School heads needs academic administrators. We have academicians, but it should be coupled with administration. Because the government of India has already given a concept of this complex, school complexes, where you know we have a lot of resources, but how best we should make use of those resources, human resources, infrastructure resources, you know, all other resources, it should be used very judiciously. And then, you know, when you really compare a private institution and a government institution, there is a management for a private institution. When you ask who is the owner of the school, definitely they come out with one name, maybe Sharma ji or Agarwal ji or maybe Nayudu or somebody. When it comes to government, who is the owner of a government school, we don't have an answer. There is no accountability, there is no responsibility. These parent committees, which actually are supposed to discharge duties, actually they have not been given the full powers. But now in Andhra Pradesh, we have also identified this problem. The parent committees have been given a lot of accountability, responsibility, power and teeth, so much so that in the renovation work also, for the first time, we have introduced the concept of community contracting. The entire restructuring of the schools, the infrastructure will be built through parent committees. And they will be the owners of the schools. They will decide the teacher-student ratio. How are the quality of the teachers? So these are the issues actually which we will be addressing, and I'm sure this integrated teacher training program will give us a lot of insights about these various issues where we are looking for some answers. And thank you so much for selecting Andhra Pradesh as the first state for starting up this Nishita program. Thank you so much, NCRT and the Government of India HRD Department. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. A. Suresh Garu. Now, request the Honorable Director NCRT to kindly introduce Honorable MOS, Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India, Professor Sanapati.
Thank you, Professor Behra. I am very happy that we are going to launch this online Nishita in the state of Andhra Pradesh. We are grateful to our minister, both the minister from Andhra Pradesh, Honorable Minister from Andhra Pradesh, who was present here and delivered his speech and shown his concern for teacher education. This is something great, because by improving quality of teacher education, really we can improve the quality of school education. I am grateful to our Honorable Minister of State, Ministry of Human Resource Development, Sri Sanjay Dhotreji, for his kind presence to launch this program. I welcome our Honorable Minister, Sri Sanjay Dhotreji, to this program. and request him to launch this online Nishtha. Sir.
Namaskar, Honorable Minister of Education, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Dr. A. Suresh Ji, Professor Hrishikesh Senapati Ji, Director NCERT, Professor N. V. Varghese Ji, Vice Chancellor NIPA, Sri B. Rajshekhar Ji, Principal Secretary, Government of Andhra Pradesh, and faculty members of NCERT, resource person, and all teachers present in this event. This is an exceptional moment. The pandemic has forced us to interact with each other largely through the virtual mode. And so, the educational transactions at all levels have also shifted to the virtual mode. As we all know, teachers have great influence on any society. In Indian tradition, we treat teachers at par with our gods. The teachers who work hard to make individuals good citizens, their sense of dedication has been aptly captured in Guru Rabindranath Tagore's work. A lamp can never light another lamp unless it continues to burn its own flame. All of us to realize this truth and remember our teachers quite fondly at different moments of life. However, as educationists and policymakers, we do also realize that our teachers too need academic support. The world has been developing at a rapid pace. In order to be in sync with this fast evolving world, our teachers also need to constantly upgrade their worldview, understanding, and methods of teaching. It is imperative across the country in the most effective manner. Our in-service teacher education system must be sensitive to the feedback from the teachers, and the teachers' individual innovations must be recognized for their pedagogic values and should become part of our standard teaching method. It is also important for us that our teachers must be very actively sensitized towards diversities of our country. Then only our children can become sensitive to the huge and different diversity is of this vast nation. With these efforts only, our children can grow up in the spirit of Ek Bharat, Shrestha Bharat, as emphasized by our Honorable Prime Minister. Keeping this in view, there has been a strong need of a uniform standard for teaching capacities across the country. Hence, the government under the leadership of Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi Ji decided to have a uniform in-service training program for government teachers across the country. And a historic and grand initiative, Nishtha, was launched almost 10 years ago by my senior colleague, Dr. Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank Ji, under Samagra Shiksha. I am aware that modules developed under Nishtha focus ultimately on holistic development of children. All the modules are centered around learning outcomes and learner-centered pedagogy. This ambitious program aims to provide training to 42 lakh elementary teachers and school heads across the country. It is not an easy task to do this in a time-bound manner. I am aware how the faculty members of NCERT have toiled hard to plan and execute this grand initiative. They have really worked in a mission mode and received very enthusiastic support from the respective state governments and their teachers. the feedback received from the ground are very encouraging. I congratulate the academic community of NCERT and its director, Professor Hrushikesh Senapati ji, for making this grand dream a reality. I also heartily congratulate the teachers and respective state governments for making this initiative success. Had the world not been afflicted by the pandemic, probably we would have been nearing the completion of this initiative.
Yes, very good.
But like everything else, this training program also had to abruptly stop. Now to take this further to the remaining teachers of country, NISHTA is shifting to the online mode. The training will be conducted through Diksha and NISHTA portals by the NCERT. NISHTA Online is a message from the MHRD towards our fight against COVID-19 pandemic that education and learning cannot be stopped. We need to find out the alternative way to move forward. It must be said, the digital technologies have truly been great enablers during the moment of crisis. Technology cannot replace good teachers, but good teachers assisted by technology can do wonders in transforming education. Under the visionary leadership of our Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi ji, we are committed to ensure value-based quality education assisted by technology for realizing Atmanirbhar Bharat. It gives me immense pleasure to be a part of the first online NISHTA program for 1200 key resource persons of Andhra Pradesh. I welcome you all on this noble journey with all the best, and especially thanks to Dr. Suresh ji and all the dignitaries. I conclude. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you very much, sir, for the kind words and the direction to all of us. Sir, actually, we are going to launch this formally. There is a few second video which will be launched by you. So we'll play for you. Thank you very much, sir. So the video was played. It was also live telecast on Swayamprabha DTS TV channel and also telecast on YouTube official channel of NCERT. And with these words, I now invite Professor Sridhar Srivastava, Joint Director NCERT, to kindly propose a formal vote of thanks. Professor Srivastava.
Thank you, Dr. Behra. Namaskar to this august presence here. And I really feel privileged to have been asked to propose a formal vote of thanks on behalf of NCERT. Before this august gathering with a noble cause here, first of all, I just want to place forth our deep respect, gratitude, and huge respect for the kind of leadership we get from our Honorable HRM, Sri Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank ji, in all our efforts in integrating content, pedagogy, and concurrent concerns of school education. We know that in this situation of pandemic COVID-19, NCERT came forward along with the support of NEPA and other institutions with many endeavors, and we always got the able leadership and support of Honorable HRM sir. And then I really wish to place on record and place forth our respect for the kind of guidance, the kind of noble words that we get from our Minister of State, Shri Dhotre Sahab. And I really feel, we really feel honored, and I can say on behalf of NCRT, for the presence that Honorable Minister of State Sahab agreed to be present on this occasion and grace the occasion with his kind words and blessings. I am really very thankful, and we feel honored by the presence of Honorable Education Minister, Andhra Pradesh Government, Sri Dr. A. Suresh Ji. Sir, we are really very encouraged by the kind of words that you put forth from the Government of Andhra Pradesh side, and the kind of commitment and words we received from your side, sir. It gives us great encouragement as a national body, and we will be always there to support the state government. Respected Madam Sri Anita Karwalji, Secretary of School Education and Literacy, we feel it always so comfortable by the kind of guidance that we receive from her, from Madam's side. I am really very thankful to Madam for all such guidance and support. We are really very happy to have with us Principal Secretary Education, School Education, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri B. Raj Shekhar Ji. And we really feel very happy that the kind of endeavors, kind of efforts, the Government of Andhra Pradesh under the guidance of leadership of Sri B. Raj Shekhar Ji is taking up, and we are very motivated by that. Director NCRT, Professor Senapati Ji, who is the head of our family, we are always with his support, and really any small or big efforts that we are making at NCRT level, the kind of leadership we are getting from his side as a head of family really is remarkable, and I feel really indebted on this occasion that this occasion could see the light of the day under your able guidance, sir. So nice of you. Thanks a lot, sir. Professor Varghese, VC Nupa, in all our efforts, and which started very recently right from the NISTA 2019 August, we have been getting the support of Nupa, sir, and by your side and by the side of your team, we are very thankful for that. And today, your presence gives us motivation. We are thankful for your presence here, sir, on this occasion. Dr. Behra and and my other colleague, Dr. Ranjana Arora, they are really the driving force behind this big effort, NISTA 2.0 online, which we are going to spearhead with the Andhra Pradesh State. I'm really very thankful for their efforts and their input day and night to meet the deadline and today make it possible so that we are launching this program today. I'm very grateful to them. And all the other faculty officers, my valued colleagues, officials from the Andhra Pradesh government, teachers who have joined this virtual launch, I am very thankful to them for their time and kind presence, kind listening to the whole deliberation. I'm really thankful to them. I informally propose a vote of thanks. The other technical persons involved in this whole launch, virtual launch, and any other staff and members who are involved in this virtual launch of this program. Even if I am missing somebody, I very deeply, from the core of my heart, I propose a vote of thanks. And so I stop here, and I am very thankful and indebted to one and all on this occasion. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Srivastava. I place on record the academic, technical, and production team of the IT to carry this program live on Swayamprabha DTS TV channel and YouTube official channel of NCERT. All the presentations, video recordings, and launch videos and show reels, including Honorable HRM's message, will be available on NISTA platform for all concerned. So nista.gov.in. So please log in and use those resources for free anytime, every time, 24/7. So thank you very much, one and all. So we formally conclude this session, and our journey begins with the state of Andhra Pradesh. Thank you very much. Namaskar.